What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about going into your Microsoft 365 tenant to retrieve somewhat a status to see whether or not your end users are reading the email that you're pushing out. So let's get right into it. All right, so today's video is all about something that I had to deal with a while back. I believe a year ago, I had this project, this video project to push out for you guys a year ago, and I never did it. So I was looking around my stuff and I found it. So a while back, I was working at a job site and they were sending out massive emails to their end users, and they wanted to figure out whether or not the end user were reading the email that they received. You know, HR, IT sends out massive emails about information, you know, and people don't really read it. When they see that it's coming from HR, from IT, what they do, they're going to delete it. So this process will show you whether or not the end user is reading it. Now, I'm going to show you how to do it for one user. Also, there's a script that I found, and I'm going to show you who actually did it. So a shout out to him. I forgot his name, but we're going to go over it during the video. But the beginning of it, I'm going to show you guys how to create an enterprise app within Azure, establish the connection with PowerShell, because you need to use Microsoft Graph API to do all this stuff. Now, open up your favorite browser, log into Microsoft 365 admin, and open up a tab. Now, once you open up a tab, we are going to type in the following address, which would be portal.azure.com. Now, the reason why I told you guys to log into Microsoft 365 Admin Center is because when you establish a new tab and you go into this particular URL, it's going to piggyback on the Microsoft 365 session that you have established already, right? Once you hit enter, it should take you here, which is good. We're going to locate the Microsoft Intra ID. So there goes, click on it. Great. On the left-hand side, we're going to click on App Registrations. Once that loads up, we're going to locate New Registration. So locate it and click on it. Now give your application a name. I gave it the following, Get Message Mail Restatus. Pretty self-explanatory, it's up to you. For the supported account type, I left it as the default. For the redirect URI, for the platform dropdown, I clicked on it and I selected web. For the web URL, I gave it the following, HTTP, localhost. On the lower left-hand side in the corner, we're going to click on register. So click on that. And on the upper right-hand side, it's going to say application created successfully, great. Now, right here in the overview of your new enterprise app that you just created, we need to copy your app ID as well as your tenant ID. So copy that stuff, place it inside the notepad because you are going to be needing that pretty soon. On the left-hand side, we are going to click on manage. So open up manage. And within here, we're going to go into certificates and secrets. So click on that. And in here, we're going to click on new client certificate. And on the right-hand side, you're going to get a submenu and give it a description. I'm going to give it the following. And expires is up to you. Recommended is 180 days, 6 months. So make sure you send out an invite to your team, letting them know that the certificate is going to expire. I would say a notification a week before it expires, you know, so you guys can renew it on time. Once you set all that stuff up, on the lower left-hand side, let's click on add. Now, once you create your new secret, make sure you copy your value, okay? Not the secret ID, the value. The value is very important. So there's three things that we need to copy: your app ID, your tenant ID, and the value of your certificates and secrets. Those three things, copy it and place it inside Notepad because we are going to be needing it pretty soon. Once you're done with this, on the left-hand side, we're going to click on API permissions. We're going to click on add a permission. You're going to get a submenu. We're going to click on Microsoft Graph. You have two options. We are going to select application permissions. And the first one that we're going to search for would be the following, directory.read.all. Once you hit enter, just give it a check mark. That's the one that we want. And we're going to do an additional search, and that search would be the following, mail.read.all. readbasic.org. Hit enter. There it goes. Give it a check mark. And on the lower left-hand side, we're going to click on Add Permissions. Boom. Now it's time for us to grant admin consent for those permissions. So where it says grant admin consent for whatever your organizational name is, we're going to click on it. You're going to get this right here. We're going to click yes. And if you pay attention to your permissions that you provided, underneath the status column, check this out. As soon as you hit yes, underneath the status is going to get a green check mark granted for whatever your organization name is. Good, right? So now it is time for us to open up PowerShell. So when you open up PowerShell, well, I like to open up PowerShell ISE, open that up as an admin. When you open that up, we're going to run the first command. This is the first command that we're going to run. Now, I'm not going to explain none of the commands because it's just going to make the video longer. And I feel like the video is longer now. So I'm just going to go really fast here. The first thing that we need to run is we need to install the Microsoft Graph module. That's what we're doing. We're going to run this. It's going to start installing all the packages. And once it's done, you're going to get this. Now, once you get installing package Microsoft Graph completed, this process takes a little bit for it to disappear. So just be patient. Eventually, it is going to disappear. The next command that we need to run is the following. We need to install the Microsoft Authentication Library module. This is the command that we need to run. We're going to run it. It's going to start running. It's going to complete. Now, next thing that we need to do is create three variables. Now, these variables, you could call it whatever you want. I call it the following: app ID, tenant ID, client secret. Now, and remember when I told you guys you needed to copy three things within your enterprise app: the tenant ID, the client ID, or your app ID, and the client secret. This is where you're going to paste it and assign it to these variables that we just defined within this PowerShell. Now, we're going to run these three variables, and it's going to store it behind the scenes because we are going to be using it pretty soon. Now, the next command that we need to run is the following, and this is going to import the Microsoft Authentication Library module. Now, we're going to create a variable, and the variable is this, and it's going to be equal to the following command, and this is where we're going to call out those variables that we created for the app ID, the tenant ID, and the client secret. Now, once you run this, we're going to run it. It's going to store that information to the variable called MSAL token. The next command that we need to do is the following. So I created another variable, and it's equal to the MSAL token.accessToken. And we need to convert that token into this variable. It's pretty weird that Microsoft changed this a lot. I didn't really need to do this a year ago, but this year, 2025, I have to do this. So once you run this command, just run it. Great. Now, once you run this, it is time for us to connect to the Microsoft Graph API. To do that, we're going to run the following command: connect MS Graph with the parameter of access token, and we're going to call out our secure token variable. So we're going to run this. As soon as you run this, you should get welcome to Microsoft Graph. That is a good thing. Great. Now, to see if you're actually connected with no problem, we're going to run a command. Now, before we run this command, there is a cap because by default, when you import a module within Microsoft Graph, I think it caps to 4,096. So we're going to increase the cap using the following: global maximum function count to 8,192. Now, I'm doing this because the command that I'm going to show you right now, which would be the following: import the module of Microsoft Graph users. If you run this import, it's going to stop and tell you it can't because it has too many modules to import into the session. I think it stops at 4,096. So running line 24 first allows you to import this particular module with no problem into this session. I'm going to run get MG user with the parameter of user ID, any user, and I'm going to select the particular parameters of user principal name and display name. If everything works well, if I run this, you should get an output, which is great. Now it's time for us to get the information to see whether or not your users or a particular user has read the email that you sent out. Now, like I said before, I didn't do this. I found this online. It is from Paul, I'm not going to say your last name because I feel like I'm going to kill it. So this is the particular PowerShell script. I have run this within production as well as testing environment. I did it within a testing environment first and then production, and it works really well. So I'm not going to go over it. Again, I'm going to post this stuff up in my GitHub. So what I did here is where it says function, that little minus, I clicked on the minus to just basically close it up. Once it's closed, I just ran the entire script. Once the script is already ran, this allows me to call out the function getMGMailReadStatus. And this is the command that I used, right? One of the parameters of this function is user ID. You're going to use the full email address. Another parameter is the subject, which is what I used here. And another parameter is show mail folder. Once you run this entire thing, it's going to go throughout your intent and it's going to show the information, which is great. And again, the parameter that we're looking for is read true. This person actually read it. If the person did not read it, it would say false. Now, if you look at the function, there's ways to actually search everyone and you would get a nice little list. And there you're able to pipe it to export it to a CSV file, clean it up, and then you're able to provide it to whomever wants to get this information, which is great. Now, one of the things that you need to do, which I forgot to tell you, is your Microsoft 365 tenant needs to have audit mode on. If you don't have that on, you're not going to get this information. So hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.